Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. In this video, I'm going to be making this custom aluminum grill shell completely from scratch. This is a five-piece construction, and I use a variety of techniques to make it, so enjoy the video. Okay, so a while ago, I made this top piece here to kind of sit on the top of the grill shell there. And this was really just a practice piece. It wasn't really my intention to actually use this. I was just kind of figuring out how I had to move the metal and what had to happen there. But I think that this piece is pretty close to what I'm actually looking for. So I'm just going to do a little bit more work to this. Hopefully I'll be able to get that to work out for the top. And then I'll have two pieces for the sides. Those will of course be welded together at the seam there. And then I'll move out from there. Okay, well, this isn't working, as you can see. I think that what's making this difficult is getting the transition from this single direction curve to this slight compound curve here up at the top where it bends over. I think what's making that hard is that this top panel doesn't come down to cover that. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to remake this panel a little bit bigger so that it covers just a couple more inches here. And then that'll make this piece a lot easier, and then I can just kind of blend them in on that straight section. Okay, so you can see I already have sort of the shape I'm going for there. What I'm doing with the mallet and the English wheel here is stretching this panel from the back to the front. Since I don't really have a shrinking tool to just shrink the front, I have to stretch everything else. So you can already see how this back part there kind of humps up in the back. That's because this metal back here has been stretched. And as I continue to do that working my way forwards, The whole panel will get a curve to it, and it'll curve this way as well. Alright, well, I'm glad I remade this top piece here because it turned out a lot nicer than the old one. And you can see this covers right down to the start of that bend there. So now I can get the side pieces that I have, I can trim the tops a little bit shorter, and it should make this a lot easier. Okay, as you can see, that bead roller is very hard on the metal here. What it likes to do is, since you're putting in that very small bend at a 90 degree angle to the actual sheet, that tries to straighten it out. So you can see the sides are out considerably from where they were, and I can't really fit it in like it was before. But I did my best to try to control that, and I think I did a pretty good job, because you can see that this line here inside of this outside lip is pretty smooth. There's no hard wrinkles in it. It's just a little bit stretched out, and I should be able to just bend that back in place and then just work this edge back in, work those wrinkles out, because fortunately those wrinkles don't really continue into the actual panel itself. Alright, well there is the finished grill shell, and I'm very happy with how this turned out. You can see that this back section where I step rolled it, I was able to straighten that out pretty nicely, so now that's a nice smooth curve. There's no real wrinkles in there. The bottom part here, you can see that's all welded up nice and solid. It's very sturdy down here. The top is going to need some sort of reinforcement because it's not too well supported up there, but that's a later issue. So the next step for this is to mount it to the frame. This is just going to bolt right onto the front cross member. I'll be doing that in the next video, as well as fitting the three-piece hood to this grill shell and the cowl, so that I'll have the whole front of the car cut to size and set in place, and you can really see what it's going to look like from that. So that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.